Good day, everyone. The summer is upon us now, and well, it will be upon us in a few weeks. But the sun is out, and it's lovely and warm. Perfect dungeon mastering weather, I would think. And run a game with your friends, out in the porch, out in the garden, or anywhere where you can enjoy the sunshine. Right, today I'm going to take a look at an adventure from Dungeon Magazine, issue 51. It's a pretty good issue. There's two adventures in there that are absolutely outstanding. And there are other adventures which are, the less said about them, the better. But it's a strong issue, purely simply because of these two adventures. Now, I'm going to cover this one called Nbod's Room. I'm not sure how you pronounce it. It could be with a silent N, Bod's Room. But I think I'll go with Nbod's Room. So the basic premise behind the adventure is there's a room in an inn, which is used by a captain whose name escapes me, Captain Nbod, that's right, Captain Nbod, and he was always afraid that he was going to get assassinated one day, pretty simply because of the criminal career that he did whilst a wild young man. So he's retired, but still being afraid of assassination, he decided to make his room with escape routes. These escape routes are portals from different parts of the world where you can sort of dash through them and be out of the way of anybody with a dagger or whatever they were used to assassinate him with. Now he's dead, but the problem is that the magic in the room has started to fade and the portals are opening at random times with different effects. And such then that the room gets a reputation of being haunted. People who witness strange smells and noises coming from within the room, and yet when they burst the door open, they'll find nothing. It just so happens that the magic shuts the portals as they're coming in. It's a coincidence. The fellow in the board is dead, but he's come back as a poltergeist, and he takes part in the adventure in a small way. As the adventure goes along, then the dungeon master will find out how and why. Now, the portals lead to a temple underneath a inn in a different city and an island somewhere in the tropic seas. On the island, there are tribesmen and creatures and a hag that's there. And the hag is the one who had killed Nbod. Previously, Nbod stole a dagger, the Leviathan dagger. Now, there's a lot packed into a 12-page model, a lot more than what you get in the usual 32 pages. It's quite dense, and the text is very involved, so you have to read it at least 4 or 5 times in order to show you get everything that goes on in there. For the playing characters, they do have an adventure that takes place in one room, which is fun. And as such, the room is in an inside an inn, and it can be played anywhere. And whatever world and milieu you have an inn that pops up somewhere, and you get the playing characters to play in that. Now, it says it can be played up to 4 levels, PC levels, or 1 to 2, with 6 total levels. And if you fancy it being a one player at 4th or 5th level. Now, with the one player 4th or 5th level, he might or she might have a chance of surviving the adventure. But the ones that the number on the first and second levels, the 4 of them, won't survive. It's purely simply because in part of the adventure, when they go to the island, there's a sort of lagoon in the middle of the island, and in there is a giant octopus type creature. And this octopus is really deadly, and the playing characters as such won't survive. They will have a real tough time unless something happens to help them. And of course they meet other creatures, harpies for one, and where's the other one then? The sea hag. Now with the octopus, right, it's going to be an 8 hit dice monster with 60 hit points. And of course with the same associated Thaco, and attacks 7 times in a round, pretty simply because of the limbs that this octopus has. Nobody should survive that if it's in a party of 1 to 2 levels. The solo at 6th level, you might have a chance because you've got a few attributes, say more spells they could use, or better weapons, what have you. But the rest of the adventure then is a little bit difficult if you take from one creature, the octopus, through to the harpies, and then through to the sea hag. Nobody's going to survive. So you have to be a bit judicious as a dungeon master in order to run that adventure properly. Of course, the characters can come back to the inn after each encounter and heal themselves up and do all sorts of things. After all, it's in the middle of a city, so they can go to the priest to get healing spells, so they jump straight back into the adventure again. As I said, it's a lot involved in this model, and as I said, it's very, very dense, and the room itself contains a lot, you know, so the playing characters can get themselves involved searching the rooms and finding the various portals that take them to different places, and so on. Also, the poltergeist is there to either give them clues to have them out if they need to, by simply producing out off the wall a picture of the captain himself to say that, yes, this is the captain, he's now a poltergeist, and so on and so forth. There's another villain in there who's a former person who worked with the captain, and he wants to find the dagger that I mentioned earlier. He believes that's going to give him quite a few powers. He's a priest who worked at the captain's pirate ship. The captain called him being a naughty boy and then banished him. So, of course, the captain had properties in different cities, and one of the portals leads to that property. So this chap called Zoon buys the property, and then every time the random spell goes off and it opens up the portal, he pops into Nbod's room and tries to find the dagger. Of course, he hasn't been successful as of yet. So while the player characters get involved in the room and find out what's going on, there's a chance that Zoom will pop in. And of course, that leads then to combat. And of course, an investigation of Zoom's temple and all the people therein. Like I said, it's a very involved module, and it's short, you know, for the amount of pages it has in the magazine, but it's packed with so much. So you'll have quite a few gaming sessions. You can also add another portal in there if you wanted to take it to another dimension or other place, just to expand the room a little bit more. But as it stands, there's quite a lot there. So I would imagine it'd be a 5, 6, 7, maybe 8 sessions of play before you exhaust all the possibilities of the room. And this appeared in a magazine, Dungeon Magazine. Dungeon Magazine number 51 provides excellent value for money. So you get not only just this adventure, but you get all the other ones in the magazine as well. But just for this adventure alone, I would say that this magazine number 51 is probably one of the better ones. So if you ever come across it, then, you know, give it a go, give it a play, and yeah, I'm sure that your playing characters, or the people who play with you, will thoroughly enjoy the game itself then, because of the way this model, or this adventure rather, has been constructed. So thank you for listening, and yep, I hope you have a nice day today. Rock on.